Buildings can cost a lot of money to build, since they don't just come out of the ground, and some buildings can be ludicrously expensive for a variety of reasons. So, what is the most expensive thing we've ever built? Starting in what you think the most obvious places to look might be, you might think that the best places to look might be somewhere like Dubai or China, and while the Middle East and Eastern Asia have both seen huge construction booms, neither area really has a building with the title of most expensive. In Dubai, the world-famous Burj Al Arab cost around $1 billion to build, and the Burj Khalifa, the tallest building in the world, cost $1.5 billion to build, which is actually somewhat inexpensive for a building of its size. China has no buildings on the top lists, unless you include Macau, whose most expensive structure is the Venetian Macau, which costs around $2.5 billion. Singapore's most expensive structure is, of course, the famous Marina Bay Sands at $5.5 billion, which beats out America's most expensive, the $5 billion Apple Park, Apple's corporate headquarters in Cupertino, California. The most expensive building on Earth is the Abraj Al Bayt in Mecca, which costs the Saudi government $15 billion to build. Though nowadays it virtually defines the skyline of the Holy City, I'm not here to talk about it today. Maybe in a future video, who knows. However, though it might be the most expensive structure ever built on Earth, it's not actually the most expensive thing we've ever built. That honor, as I'm sure I've already hinted, goes to the International Space Station, which costs over 10 times the amount it costs to build the Abraj Al Bayt at $160 billion. So, what went into building this thing? Perhaps unsurprisingly, the majority of the cost of the ISS came from transporting it to its location. If you ever played Kerbal Space Program long enough, you'll know pretty well that space stations don't function very well when they're not in space. And since the entire point of the ISS was to be in a zero-g vacuum environment and to house 6 people at a time there, this was a pretty non-negotiable detail. The thing is, however, though the ISS is small fry compared to the buildings that make up the skylines of Dubai and Singapore, it's still nothing to sneeze at. The ISS is about 109 meters by 73 meters wide and weighs, or masses, 417 tons, which for anything flying is pretty massive. Now, the ISS is in space, and space is a pretty terrible place to build foundations. So the space station needs to be high and going fast. And this means rockets. Rocket launches can be expensive, but the ISS wasn't built in a single launch, but over the course of dozens of launches to send new modules, exchange crew, and to bring new supplies. The space shuttle was launched there 26 times just to bring up new modules, not counting crew exchanges and supply reruns. The ISS actually started in 1998 with the Russian Zarya module, and wasn't complete until 2011. Owning up to its name, the International Space Station was mainly built by the US, who contributed about $100 billion, along with the EU, Russia, Japan, and Canada, who really likes to gloat about it. It wasn't just building the ISS that was expensive, maintaining the ISS is also monstrously expensive, at around $3 billion every year, twice the cost to build the Burj Khalifa. And this is all up against NASA's federal budget, which for 2018 was $19.1 billion. Maintaining the ISS is a whole new ordeal, especially when it's staffed, which it usually is. And many have wondered if it's even worth the investment. It is. The problem is, though objects in geostationary orbit can more or less stay stable for thousands of years, objects in low Earth orbit can't even remain dormant for the economic or political climate down on Earth to improve, since, being still well inside the exosphere, their orbits are gradually decaying, and so they need a boost every once in a while. The ISS may have brought most of the spacefaring world together, but if relations sour, the ISS often has to be shielded from the hit list. In 2014, after sanctions were enacted on Russia for their invasion of Crimea, the ISS was pretty much the only thing that NASA and Roscosmos collaborated on, just to keep the thing operational and safe. Unfortunately, the ISS currently looks as if it might not survive out of the 2020s, due to its high cost. I'd start a bake sale for it, but that probably wouldn't be enough, and also it can't bake very well. Thank you for watching this video, and if you enjoyed it, please be sure to give it a like, share it, and subscribe to learn something new every Sunday. Also, what do you think? Should the ISS remain open past 2028? I would personally say a resounding yes, for obvious reasons, but I'm curious about your opinion. Let's have a discussion about it in the comments below, because that totally never goes wrong.